volume, and I gotta listen to Zydeco music to and from work. I hate Zydeco.
Weird looking folks checking into the Royal yesterday. I think they were you.
You the reporter?
Harold Cawley, the Tattler. I'm covering D'Orazio's little corruption racket.
Can't imagine it's good for your health, naming names in the Marcano organization.
Didn't you hear? Even cigarette smoke will kill you. So here's what I know. We've got city officials taking bribes, blackmail, juicy stuff. At the center of it all is a fellow named Frankie Bernard. The problem is, I don't know where he operates.
Might make it kind of hard to find him.
Ah, but the thing is, I hear Mr. Bernard uses debt drops. Spots where his people leave bribes for officials to pick up. And I just happen to know where they are. I also understand Frankie keeps a sweet blackmail stash of every dirty deal he's done.
I'll see if I can't get one of those couriers to give up the location for your mystery man and his little blackmail stash.
The people working for Bernard are just as secretive as he is. You might have to find some way to get them to talk.
Sidestep integration. Technically, the landlord can point at that and tell your colored friends to be on their way.
Frankly,
the case is a loser, a non-starter. So, of course, I'll take.
I think he split.
Got a discount!
He's gunning us down! I'm ducking down! Get on his other side!
You're gonna tell me what you know about Frankie Bernard.
Mr. Bernard has some bag men making drops.
Got an angle.
All
ready.
I know is the kind of car they're driving.
Thanks for your help.
I'm assuming we ain't grabbing a beer after this.
Thank you.
misunderstood because of the way they dress. I told them what they're wearing has nothing to do with it. It's their dress and cowardice that's offensive to me.
Fucking snitch. You know things are tight. It's one envelope.
Just one? That's my goddamn point.
Man, you wanna remember they take folks out to the bayou for less.
Drop!
Get me, you dirty fucking coon!
You're gonna tell me what you know about Frankie Bernard.
The boss is running things out of the Imperial Bath Health Spa. He's keeping the politicians in line with dirty pictures he's got stashed there.
So much blood.
You can thank me later.
All the blood.
Guess he beat feet, sneaky son of a bitch.
Beat feet, cocksucker! Coming through.
Watch what you're doing.
That amusement park's been closed a while. Wonder what that boy was doing there.
Huh?
Can't stay.
Running for cover.
I can't die.
Shit. How you like that?
That man just got shot.
Don't take more than you to hurt me.
Your time is up, motherfucker!
We got ourselves a... Yo, bastard, got lucky!
Get around him! Look
looks like a leg. Only so many places to hide.
Poor bastard didn't stand a chance.
Come tell us.
Get that stupid son of a bitch!
Time to die, prick!
Guess we put the field. Where'd he skip off to? I said we try that area.
Yeah, you know you want.
Come try killing me!
Now, why did you want to go and rip off Mr. D'Orazio?
I'm sorry! Tell Mr. D'Orazio I'll do anything to make it right! Anything!
Oh, anything? Try flying, you sticky-fingered piece of shit!
Thank you. get to the phone.
For a resupply downtown.
I'll head your way now.
You spot anything you can use, guess what? Good. Call me if you need.
See that?
I know you're working for Kavar. Tell me what he's up to.
Mr. Kavar just moved a shit ton of stuff, and the money's just sitting there, waiting for somebody to take it.
Can't have you talking.
I
You fucking pieces of shit, I'm dead! Dead, you hear me? I'll tell you fucking die out, and I'm never gonna find you!
I fucking vouched for you with Mr. Cabal, both of you pricks! You didn't think we'd find out?
Motherfucker's got business to attend to.
You see what he's carrying?
You doing?
Can't believe it's raining again.
Hey, stone it.
All right, dude.
He about to get an education. It's go time, boy.
Fuck Austin.
Heading for cover.
Give me a hand here.
You don't want
Get down. He's gonna come. Come over like fucking flies.
No trouble.
I ain't seen nothing.
Oh, motherfucker.
That shit's all him. Let's go! All right, just stay.
Gavar construction is a wreck.
Forgive me,
Mr.
Please.
Gavar's really peeved. Jimmy Gavar called. He's at the City Hall construction site and wants to see me. He knows. I don't know how, but he knows I've been helping you people. He's gonna kill me, or I'm going to jail. Then he'll kill me. Oh, God.
Go home to your wife, Lenny. Pack a bag, get out of town for a couple days. When you get back, this will all be over.
You'll talk to Jimmy?
Sure.
Kavar's waiting for you. I'm gonna follow your advice. Get out of town.
Forgive me, please.
I'm downtown and about ready for a resupply.
I'll head your way now.
You want something? You
let
me know.
Show me what you got.
I'll be...
Run! Run! Stop! Give me a hand!
Some cover!
Cocksucker!
Boy is
quick as steel. Get away. We can't see you. Duck, give me a hand.
Getting out of here.
Good Lord, that fucking hurts.
I'm empty.
Fucking dropping us.
I'll be right down here.
Yours cuts mine. I got that cocksucker.
Tony D is gonna bury me. You hear? Bury me.
Worrying about the wrong man, Jimmy. Send whoever you got downtown. We gotta secure it while we can.
Yeah, okay. But if you asking me to commit the lives of my men here, then I expect you to commit to me. And remember, this road we're setting out on in the here and now.
Anyone who thinks Sammy Robinson was the Mardi Gras mastermind is a moron. Just because he was involved doesn't mean it was his idea. And none of the evidence ever added up. The money wasn't recovered, and Sammy didn't shoot himself in the back of the head and then burn down his own bar. The only reason people believe Sammy was behind it was his skin color.
Fuck him up! Getting behind something!
We're gonna lose the whole goddamn day over this. You know that, don't you?
Sir, it's not my fault.